Okay, this is tying this high line up. What I've done is I'll zoom in and I'll go over there. Hopefully you can hear me. Why do you leave that bottle on? What are you doing, drinking beer over there, boy?
So basically what I did right here is, as I showed you on the other one, I just did a bowline. I just tied this around a nice, big, strong tree. I got a bowline knot here, so my high line's gonna be running this way. Then I went ahead and took these, I told you how to make two bowline knots and connect them and run them through. So I put the two bowline knots to connect this to give me a little bit longer rope between these two. And now, I'll show you how I hooked it up over here. Once I readjust, Mr. T and Buddy are like, dude, what are you doing?
The idiot camera's telling me I'm panning too fast. You guys can't see that. So Buddy's over there. He found a beer bottle. So he's having a drink before we go out riding. Mr. T's over here like, dude, what the hell are you doing? And now I'm going to try and keep this right in this area right there to show you how I kind of hook this line up. And hopefully see it.
I can barely see this damn little lens out here.
Oh, it won't let me turn it hard.
Well, hopefully I'll stay in there. Kind of see. So, now that I have my high line over here. Hi, Mr. T. I'm going to get those flies out of his eyes so he's not so. So my high line's going to go here, so I need to check the second point. So I'm going to use this big limb up here. I'm going to make sure you can see that limb that I'm going to use.
And it's above.
So now I gotta throw this rope over the limb I'm gonna use. Stupid rope didn't go over the tree. I did this before I turned on the camera and it worked fine. Stupid camera. Alright. So this is gonna be my high line. I'm just gonna tie this real quick. I wanna make sure you can see this. What I wanna do, make sure you can see that. Oh no, don't pull my rope down, dummy. Alright, I think I'm in the camera here. So now what I need to do is do that little slip knot we were talking about. So I'm going to put a slip knot right here. And when you do the slip knot, I want this rope is going to be pulling. So I want to make sure when I turn this that this comes through this way. So when I untie it, this makes the knot smaller. And then I'm going to run my other end of my rope through here. And that's gonna give me my leverage to pull this rope nice and tight. And now, I still think I'm in. I'm gonna use this tree here to help me with a little more leverage. Oh man, so that's pretty tight there. And now what I'm gonna do, so I don't lose this tension here on this rope, because I'm gonna have horses tied to it and I want that tension. I'm gonna give one more pull and then I'm just gonna wrap this around this tree here to give me a bite. Now I don't need a whole lot of pressure on tying that knot because this twist is holding it. So I'm gonna twist one more time and now that's gonna hold all this tension and now I can do a nice easy little just loop or slip knot here because I already have tension. On this, and again you can use whatever knot you want once you have other tension, but this bind right here, and now this rope should be tight enough to hold me, and it is. So that's my high line. Hopefully you can see that because I can't see this damn camera.
And if you notice, Mr. T's like, dude, let's get that damn rope. So I'm gonna try and zoom in on the high line there. I got it around that tree. That's my little slip knot. That's where I just looped it around a couple times. The rope goes all the way across. So right there where my two bowline knots connect my rope to make it longer because it wasn't long enough. And then there's my other anchor point with a bowline knot on a big tree over there. And basically that's setting up a high line. So now I'm at 5 minutes. I'll change Mr. T. You notice Mr. T is tied to this tree here. So I'm gonna tie him to the high line to where he can move. So, and if you notice here, his knot, that's a bowline right there. So I'm gonna take that knot off and I'm gonna put that same knot up on the tree up here.
Hi, Mr. T.
And now Mr. T can move.
So again, remember on these bowlines, you make a little loop for your hole with the tree. The rabbit runs through the hole, runs around the tree, and then back down the hole. So if I want this loop before he runs through the hole, I gotta throw this over my high line. And now the rabbit goes through the hole, around, back down. I have a bowline knot here. Mr. T can slide back and forth and go where he wants now. He's on a high line.
All right, I think I got all that in. If I didn't, tough. And now Buddy and Mr. T, Buddy's like, dude, I'm glad I'm not tied to that stupid tree. All right, we'll end that there. Hope that helps on putting up a high line. Again, I've got a chart. I'll put a link to, I think it's on either on the knot page or the rope page somewhere. If you search my site, I've got a search engine on the homepage. And if you put knot, you'll probably get all the pages that that I mentioned knots. But there's some good pictures with a lot of different knots. Knowing good knots, having good soft rope that you can manipulate and tie is good. If you try to use some crappy stiff rope that somebody's put out by the pasture and horses have chewed on and used it as dental floss, it's probably not going to hold and your horse is going to get loose. But again, if you're highlining, your horse should already know to give to pressure. Your horse should already know that pulling doesn't get free. Your horse should already know all this, so you don't put them on that. I mean, I could probably highline my horses with hay string and they wouldn't break the hay string. Now, if they got spooked and a tiger came up and chased them, they'd probably break it. But just standing around, you know, I'm not that worried about it. If they get loose, they get loose. It's not like it's the end of the world. It's not like a horse is gonna run to the next county. You know, the old saying is, horse wants to run, let him run. There's, you know, in America anyway, there's oceans on both sides, so let him run. As long as he's going east or west, he's gonna hit water soon. But he ain't gonna get that far, so, I'm not too worried about them getting loose. A high line is more of it's a way to secure them if you have nothing else. If you got 2 points, you want to put multiple horses. My buddy's coming out here with his 2 horses, so we're going to have 4 horses on this high line here in a few minutes. And we'll see how it holds. And if it gets loose, hey, shit happens. Buddy, Mr. D, you're good boys. Dad's gonna ride you guys. You're gonna be tired from carrying Dad's fatty all day. Well, that there, hope that helps.